So if any of such anything such movement opened up, you are welcome to share with the people so that others also get benefit. There's a group learning happens. So may I request Lavanya?
Because there is no point in saying all pervading reality became you.
Space is everywhere it entered into you, there's no point in saying. That appeared in your body and your body is alive. You can feel the aliveness in the body. That aliveness has come from the eye. This is called consciousness. And that manifestation of consciousness in your body is called Chidabhasa. Okay? The small eye, the Chidabhasa or the small eye, the Chidabhasa or consciousness manifest in your body associates with the thought called I, and they work together. The Chidabhasa or Chidabhasa is the manifestation of consciousness in your body, which is like, exactly like I consciousness. All pervading space is there in your body, in your room also. And all pervading consciousness are here also. And that is appearing in your body. But that consciousness is associated with a thought called I, the small I. This small I, which is I thought, it is in the mind. And the consciousness, Chidabhasa, together is called Jiva. The consciousness and a thought called I is called Jiva. Now this consciousness called Chidabhasa, it is alive. You see, you can feel it, right? The body is alive, everything aliveness. That's the consciousness which has manifested. The divine, the God, Brahman has manifested in you as Chidabhasa. You can feel it, you can sense it. So that consciousness associates with thought and it forgets that I am from the I. It forgets the reality called big I and it starts thinking that I am a small I. So that guy is in trouble. And that I is called Jiva. The small I plus Chidabhasa is together called Jiva. We'll find out. We'll get into more detail of that. Okay? This to give a pictorial view of what's happening. So there is a consciousness, there is a manifestation of consciousness in your body called Chidabhasa. There is a mind which is nothing, we are very familiar, friend. Keeps on talking. Okay? And the mind also says I. The Chidabhasa associates the I, the small I, rather than the big guy. And the small eye takes control of the body and experiences the world. Is this clear from the picture? Anybody has a question on this? Yeah, chit abhas. Chit means consciousness. Abhas means reflection. Reflective consciousness. Because, see, there's no point in saying all infinity is appeared in the body. Because it's already there. But the body seems to be alive because of that. That's because of the Chidabhasa. It's a manifestation of the eye. Manifestation.
Okay. Raw molecules in the head, it is more effective.
I mean?
The raw thing, because the board.
And right here? Even this board, you want me to say, draw the board? See, there's a pure consciousness called I, which is Brahman or Supreme Reality or pure consciousness, all pervading. Okay, all pervading space is in this room also, there's no point in saying that. But that appears in your mind as a reflection. This is called Chidabhasa. So now this develops a concept called small eye. This is a big eye. This small eye, which is actually reflected consciousness in the mind, takes the form that I, the small eye, and starts taking the control of the world. The small eye is, this combination small eye is called ego. Now entire spiritual teaching is drop the small eye, which means drop the thought. Okay? You cannot drop the thought because it's not real. Why it's not real? Fine. So really you, what you call as you, is Chidabhasa. The consciousness manifesting this body is you. And the Chidabhasa has to identify with the big guy, not the small eye. Okay, that is spiritual. That's the essence of spirituality. How to do that, we'll find out. Is it okay? ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಇರಬೇಕಾ
ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ
ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಚಿತ್ ಚಿತ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ. ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಇದೆ. ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಇಲ್ದಿದ್ದ ಜಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಆಕಾಶಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ, ಆಯಿತಾ? ಅದು ಸೂರ್ಯ ಇದ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಆ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಬೆಳಕು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಬೀಳ್ತದೆ. ನದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೀಳ್ತದೆ, ಕೆರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೀಳ್ತದೆ. ಕೆರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿದ್ದಾಗ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲನ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲನ ಕೂಡ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಇದ್ದಾಗಿದೆ. ಆದರೆ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲವೇ ನಾವು ಜೀವ ಚೈತನ್ಯ. ಈ ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಅದರ ಶಕ್ತಿನೇ ಇದೆ. ಯಾವುದು? ಚೈತನ್ಯದ್ದು. ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಬೆಳಕಿಗೆ, ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಬೆಳಕಿದ್ದ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲನಕ್ಕೂ ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ. ಇದು ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ, ನಾನು ನೀರು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತದೆ. ಇದು ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಬೆಳಕಿನ, ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ. ಈ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲನ ಅದೇ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ, ನಾನು ಈ ಕೆರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಈ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ, ನಾನು ದೇಹ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ. ಅದು ಜೀವ. ಚಿದಾಭಾಸಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕು? ನಾನು ದೇಹ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕು, ರೈಟ್? ಅದೇ ಜ್ಞಾನ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಚಿದಾ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸನ್. ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಸನ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇ ಲೇಕ್. ಒನ್ ಲೇಕ್, ಮಿರರ್, ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಈಚ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಓಕೆ? ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಸನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಸನ್, ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ. ಚಿತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಅಭಾಸ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಓಕೆ? ದ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಐ, ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ. ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸನ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲೇಕ್, ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಲೇಕ್, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಸನ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ? ಇನ್ ಇಟ್. ದ ವಾಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಅಲೈವ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ, ಚೈತನ್ಯ, ಓಕೆ? ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ. ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌ ದ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಐ, ದಿ ಥಾಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಐ, ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಐ, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟ್ರಬಲ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್, ಜನರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್.
Because of this
reflection of consciousness,
pure eye and small eye, that is the cause for many jivas.
Yes.
This reflection.
Yes. This reflection is what jiva is. The reflection has all the characteristics of the original. But reflection is confusing itself with the body. Okay? So the spiritual teaching is to understand. I'll speak in Kannada, then I'll speak in English also. Even if you don't understand Kannada, please repeat. ನಾನು, ನಾನೆಂಬುದು, ನಾನಲ್ಲ, ಈ ದೇಹ, ಮನಬುದ್ಧಿ, ನಾನಲ್ಲ, ಸಚಿದಾನಂದಾತ್ಮ, ಶಿವನಾನ್ ನಾನೇ, ಶಿವೋಹಂ, ಶಿವೋಹಂ, ಶಿವೋಹಂ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್, I am not the intellect.
I am pure consciousness.
Shivaswarupi. For whom is the teaching? For the reflected consciousness, Chidabhasa, which is confusing itself with the body. That is the teaching. Once Chidabhasa recognizes that I am the I, the teaching is over. Right now Chidabhasa is thinking I am the body, because I am inside the body. Somebody told earlier, the consciousness is trapped in the body. The consciousness is not trapped in the body, it appears to be trapped in the body because of the mind. Shall we proceed further? Any questions? Ha! Many people have gone through spiritual journey. Something looks like this, you have seen?
Snake and ladder.
See, actually snake and ladder is an interesting game which was designed by our ancestors to teach children about spirituality. Okay? So what is spirituality? Spirituality, it's called moksha pata, or it's called paramapada. For small children, they had to give spiritual education. They gave through a game called snake and ladder. Okay, the snake and ladder, you have to keep playing and you move from house to house. So moving from house to house is called karma. Okay, you can get to move from one house to house, and the next level is called next level loka. Next level From there are in our ancient folklore, there are many lokas. Bhuloka, Bhuvaloka, Swarloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka. So movement from one loka to other loka was shown by through levels. And movement can happen through a ladder, which is like your karma, or it can be a grace. And from the first point to last point, there will be a big ladder. You will get a jump actually, a huge jump. And that huge jump is called grace.
Here, both is given as karma and movement also is given as karma.
No, actually, I think it's Vishnu Kripa. The home is actually pushing what you are putting. It's a horizontal movement, karma. Home is just where you are now. So you are moving your action. Karma is taking you next level in that. Suddenly you get a boost, which is a ladder, which is a good karma or a grace. And snake is nothing but vasanas, impressions. Okay? Oh, I'm in trouble. Okay, I have done good or bad, all those thoughts will come. That will you drop. So there's a good karma, there's a bad karma, and there's a grace. In this, there is no ladder shown because this guy doesn't understand moksha pata. There is a big ladder, which is called moksha. No. The big ladder will take you straight to moksha. But instead of big ladder, I have shown one ladder now, one arrow mark. That arrow mark is called direct path. Okay, the direct path is what is the teaching which you are going through. Okay? You can. This is like a where you start today. Prabhu karma. Okay, so you keep moving. Then moving from level to level, sometimes you fall back, sometimes you go up. Okay, go on and on. And
vasanas are our inherited traits from impressions.
Impressions.
Can you just correlate and explain it to snakes?
The snakes, actually, this we have what you call impressions, vasanas. Okay, vasanas is nothing but impression. In impression, vasanas you can tell in Sanskrit it's called vasana. It's a habit pattern. For example, somebody is alcoholic, he drinks alcohol. Okay? And doctor tells him your liver is getting damaged. Stop drinking alcohol. He can't stop. Next moment he sees a bottle, he'll drink again. There's a habit pattern which is forcing him. Like that, there are many impressions or vasanas we develop in life. And these vasanas, I am trying to move towards make improvement of my life. I am trying to develop good qualities. Some of my impressions will come back and fall back. For example, I want to chant God's name on 10,000 times. After 2,000 times, I get bored. So I'll fall back. So like that, these vasanas are our habit patterns or impressions which are developed over a period of time. Okay? So, why I told you this? Because the spiritual education started at a very, very early age in India. Okay, children were taught. And even the spiritual education in India started in sometimes prenatal stage. The child is in the mother's womb. The mother and father used to give spiritual education. Okay? And that is the reason our country was called Bharat. Bha means the wisdom. Rat means the, what you call as joy, the bliss. The peak country of people who were immersed in bliss of the self-knowledge is called Bharat. Because education system was from the prenatal stage, nursery, the spiritual education was given. And they designed game like this. And there is another game which they designed in Indians design. That's called hide and seek, Kannamuche. Many people don't know Kannada here, but I'll just tell what is that song. Kannamuche, Kade, Gude, Uddina Mote, Urule Hoitu, Namma Haki, Nimma Haki, Hari Hoitu. So that is the song. That song is teaching entire spirituality in one small song for children, plain children. Kannamuche, I have closed my eyes. I have lost. Who am I? I am lost in the forest. Okay? I have become ignorant. The Achi means wise man. It represents the guru. Okay? So then he teaches one person and that person goes. Now he has become free. Now whenever somebody he touches, that becomes also a person free. He has become free from the ignorance. So that is the game of enlightenment was called Kannamuche Kadebude. Okay, that was a song. Okay, this snake and ladder is actually about spiritual path. There are many things our ancestors had done, innovation, one of small things. I'll just show you one small song. And queens. The mother also was an enlightened queen. She gave birth to children, and one of the child, the moment it's born, we do the naming ceremony. The naming ceremony becomes the seed for the ego. I am separate. Okay? The child started crying. The mother, for the 7-day-old baby, she teaches the Atmadnana or self-knowledge.